Within our hub, A Healthy Start and Life Course for All, we are developing evidence-based and context-driven child and parent care for all European citizens by collaborating with the social domain and governments, as well as with the tech, consumer, food and behavioral sectors. We bring together evidence and insights from a wide range of disciplines.
Improved care for people starts with new knowledge. And new knowledge is being created by scientific research. And new knowledge in my field of my profession, being obstetrics and prenatal medicine, concerns two new insights. First of all, that we know that growth and development of the fetus during pregnancy is related to the health of the newborn baby. But not only that, it's also related to health later in life. And we know now that not only fetal development in the second half of pregnancy, but already development in the first weeks of pregnancy, during the first 10 weeks of pregnancy, is also already related to the health of a newborn child. So we have to change the way we care for pregnant women. Normally, pregnant women go to their midwives or general practitioners or obstetricians when they're about 10 weeks of gestational age. But because those early weeks are already important, we have to start care earlier on, and that means before pregnancy. Otherwise, you're simply too late. We call this preconception care. And what we try to organize is that couples who wish to become pregnant, who wish to become to have a child, already go to a midwife or a general practitioner before they get pregnant and have a discussion about possible risks and to make a plan how to become pregnant in a healthy way. And that means, for example, to improve nutrition, to avoid dangerous lifestyles like smoking and the use of alcohol, but also, for example, in chronic conditions, avoidance of the use of dangerous medication. So that's an important first possible way to change the way we care for pregnant women. Also, the second new insight has consequences for the way we provide care. As the social environment is very much important and determines the risks of a pregnant woman and a newborn child, we have to involve municipalities and social care and to combine it with medical care in providing care for pregnant women. And that means that we have to team up with municipalities and the way they provide their social care to be able to tailor it to the individual needs of people and those couples who live in those deprived areas. We have done this, for example, in Rotterdam, and we've done this now in large parts of the Netherlands, in which, together with municipalities and together with the Ministry of Health, we developed tailored care pathways, as we call it, to be able to also deal with social risks like teenager pregnancies, drug use, debt problems, financial debt problems of people, and also housing problems. And in that way, we hope that we can also reduce stress of those pregnant women and to be able to improve their chances of having a healthy child with a healthy future.
This hub will bring together researchers, healthcare providers and policymakers all involved in pregnant women and young children. And it will give a unique opportunity to study how early life affects later life health and disease, so actually across the full life course. One of the important projects in this hub is the Generation R study. The Generation R study is a big population-based prospective cohort study in the city of Rotterdam. We actually follow 10,000 women and their children for almost now 13 years. Major outcomes in this study are focused on mental health, on cardiovascular health, on respiratory health, but also on eye development, tooth development and hearing, for example. We have a lot of important findings in this study. For example, we know now that the earliest phase of life, so early pregnancy, the first trimester of pregnancy, the growth in the period of the child in the womb is really important and it's related to cardiometabolic health of the children. But we can also see very big differences in social background and ethnic background in all kinds of diseases like respiratory health, like tooth problems, like myopia. So all kinds of childhood disorders already have their origins in early life, but also are different between these ethnic and social groups. The other study that we have is the Generation R Next study, and that's actually the follow-up of the Generation R study. In that study, we will specifically focus on women before pregnancy, because we really think that's a very important period. We include women already in the preconception period, so we ask women which are just thinking to have a child in the upcoming 2 years. We do a lot of ultrasounds, blood tests, of course. We do a lot of embryonic measurements on the first part of pregnancy. And of course, we will follow up these children after birth. So these studies are really exciting, important, and do lead to a lot of new research questions also, which can be answered in this new hub, Healthy Start.
A healthy start in life for all is truly at the center of society and can only be addressed by considering multiple elements simultaneously that each have their specific contribution and reinforce each other. Basic and translational research will result in innovation followed by implementation of evidence-based approaches. This will enable true societal valorization of knowledge, bringing new solutions and interventions to society. In this way, stimulating, for example, positive behavioral change in current and future mothers and fathers.